Right of Education. English conversation practice for the oral test of the Italian School Managers Competition. Part 4. Right of Education, Right of Study in Italy. The right and duty to education and training. The training system includes school education, post-compulsory education, professional training, post-secondary education, professional training, higher and technical education, and apprenticeships. It is established as a state service in accordance to Article number 3 and Article number 117 of the Constitution. Over the past 10 years, the law has fluctuated between two expressions, compulsory education, right to education, and legally sanctioned right and duty to education and training, but founded on the principle that the lower level of education is compulsory and free for at least 8 years. In Article 34 of the Constitution. In 1999, Article 1 of Law Number 9, on the initiative of former Minister Luigi Berlinguer, has determined that the obligation of education has arisen from 8 to 10 years. Article 68 of Law 17 May 1999, number 44, in turn, established the compulsory attendance to training activities. All those citizens who have completed their compulsory education don't benefit after the age of 15 years, they have the right and duty to continue up to 18 years of age their training with the education service, choosing among three systems, secondary school, regional training, and apprenticeship contract. The implementing regulation of Article 68 of Law 144 in 1999 were enacted with the DPR number 257 of 12 July of 2000 and are still in force. Instead, Law number 9 of 1999 was repealed by Minister Moratti, who has retained the compulsory education to the age of 18 years, not revoking Law number 144 of 1999 or DPR number 257 of 2000. A heated controversy arose around the dilemma of whether or not the compulsory training had the same legal cogency and educational effectiveness of the compulsory education. Minister Moratti claimed that the right and duty to education and training extends the concept of compulsory education, widening the area from the path of education to that of professional training. In contrast to the Moratti reform, others have argued that the right duty to education and training annuls the right to education, concealing the substantial reduction in the education service to 8 years. This is because many students, having completed the secondary school at 13 and a half years old, are inclined or inclined to choose early professional training or makeshift apprentice, alternating school and work, higher education and training. As in the reform cycle, so law number 30 of 2000, in the Moratti and Gelmini reforms, the education and school work systems are considered unitary. The professional and education training system is solely the region's responsibility, but Ministry of Education, in agreement with the State Regions Joint Conference, established the rules for determining the minimum educational standards for the marketability of professional work qualifications and for the transit from a training to a school path. Confindustria sees the linkage between the school and the work world as a functional model for economic growth, capable to contribute in improving the quality of the made in Italy, and in some manufacturing sectors has detected an excess demand by companies with comparison to availability of skilled labor supplied with the diploma. 180,000 technical jobs not covered. In the law 107 of 2050, there is alternating school and work compulsory in high school, all high school, also gymnasium and liceum. The higher education and training courses IFTS were established by the Article 69 of law number 144 of 17 May 1999. This is a post-secondary at university level and arts, music and dance, high level training and polycentric education involving the state and the local government pursuant to legislative decree of 112 in 1998. Educational society, lifelong learning. In a society characterized by the production system dynamism, innovations in the work world tend to displace the skills which were acquired at school. Therefore, the training recurrence articulated into professional update or retraining cycles and workforce conversion is not only in the interest of the employed, but also of the social economic system. Mario Reguzzoni has been the most important expert of this strategy in Italy. The recurrent education is included in the extended education In other words, the possibility for the citizens to benefit from education and training periods not necessarily during childhood and adolescence age, where the motivation and aptitude to study might be inadequate. Learning should not be limited to the first part of life. In the educating society context, all circumstances can lead to learning processes. The term continuing education was formulated by Bernard Schwartz in 1972, indicating all forms of learning in the space-time continuum of human life. Currently, there are several denominations: lifelong learning, continuing education, recurrent education, adult education, educating society, continuous education, each of which designates one aspect. Measures have been taken on adult education, such as the law OM, Ministerial Ordinance of the July 29 in 1997, number 455, which have structured the permanent territorial centers for basic skills and literacy of the immigrants. In 2010, the general rules for the redefinition of the organizational educational center for adult education have rationalized the concept by channeling all the provincial center for adult education, CPIA, by forming educational pathways with two levels, the first leading to the achievement of the qualification at the end of the first cycle and to a certification of completion of compulsory education, the second leading to a technical, professional or artistic diploma. Equal public school. The non-state schools, namely the regional and equal schools, fall into a full public education systems. The recognition of the public nature of the service they provide postulates that they are no profit entity and are open to the general public. Therefore, equal schools are recognized as examination centers for eligibility exams and for state exams taken at the completion of courses, diploma or professional qualifications realized by those schools have the same legal value as those realized by public schools, public statal state schools. The region's financial capability established under Title V, Part 2 of the Constitution is governed by the Legislative Decree number 112 of the 31 March in 1998, which established that it is the region's task to define economically the assistance to the school and the right to education, by helping removing any economic, social and cultural obstacles that could prevent its implementation. In the 2009-2010 school year, the Ministry of Education has devised the plan of apportionment of resources to the regions, which in turn redistribute them to the municipalities for payment to families, for the right to education, which has involved a loan of 680 million euros, while the regional one totals 506 million of euros.